another Doctor Who review. Crikey, it's been a little while since we've done one of these. Today we're looking at History of the Daleks number 1, based on the story The Daleks, as you can see here, which came out in 1963, a year where we had wonderful movies coming out such as The Birds, The Great Escape featuring the great Donald Pleasance, and nothing bad was ever happened
to the Kennedys!
But anyways, with that out of the way, let's carry on with the review. The two Daleks come in this collector-friendly and very stylish box, with a nice big window giving us a look at the Daleks, with the window carrying around on top so we can see them from above. The side of the box gives us a lovely little picture of the TARDIS, something which becomes standard with these boxes, with a quick turn to the back giving us a view of the product inside, with a brief description of the story, and something that's quite interesting, a actual description of the history of the Dalek props themselves. Pause the video and give it a read, it's quite interesting. Upon opening the box, we get quite a lovely little surprise, where we get this lovely rendition of the Dalek City slash Dalek hallway. And weirdly enough, upon looking at it, I actually found myself feeling like it was an optical illusion. Zooming in makes you feel like you're actually walking down this thing. There was a little Easter eggs on the box art, such as this weird little camera thing, and the best Easter egg of all, a scuff mark, just like the original 1963 set. I can't believe this attention to detail. Now, taking these guys out the box, they are really a lovely pair to look at, with that bright silver definitely being done up from their 2008 counterpart, with some subtle variations between them that actually helped to add quite a little bit of character. As you can see here, the most striking difference between the 2008 counterpart and this one is probably the silver and just how bright it looks, and honestly, it's gorgeous. The silver really sort of makes them pop and makes them feel just quite sort of bright, and a lovely addition to your shelf. They even went up and did the silver on the gun a little bit better than the original, which is a lovely little touch and a lovely little attention to detail. Though, as lovely as the silver is, mine seems to have this weird issue where the silver has either been reapplied or come off, adding this weird scuffed look, which I will let slide considering that it adds to the sort of authentic scuffed feel of the original 1963 props. There also seems to be a little bit of issue with some slight paint bleed, which honestly isn't that big of a deal. Despite looking almost identical, the difference between these two figures is that they actually, despite sharing the same eye stalk sculpt, have different sized irises. This is actually accurate to the props of the time, which were fitted with hexagonal shapes in the eye stalks, allowing the eyes to sort of increase and decrease, almost like they were focusing on things. Just like in this clip.
To teach these human beings the law of the Daleks!
Spooky. The dark grey on the torso is really nice as it sort of contrasts the bright silver that's seen all around the body. These wonderful paint jobs actually continue all the way around onto the back of the Dalek, where a nice little Easter egg to the original props can be found, that being these black marker lines. This is actually a nice little callback to the original props, in which that these Daleks would have a different number of lines on their backs, so that the prop makers at the time could actually tell which Dalek was which, to use in the stories. This is a feature that I only just noticed is missing on the original Dalek release. Another lovely little reference to the original props is that on the bottom of one of the Daleks is that you can actually see these sort of grey scuff marks, which is an issue that plagued the early props, where they would bump into things and get scuffed all over.
Bugger!
Moving on to articulation, the Dalek's plunger arm can move up, as well as down, as well as from side to side. The plunger arm can do the same, going up and down, side to side, as well as all around in a sort of 360. The Dalek's eye stalk can move up, as well as back down. The Dalek's head as well is able to do a full 360 degree rotation, nice and smoothly. This articulation is something that becomes standard with all Dalek figures, new series and old. But with that out of the way, that is this review done. This is a lovely little pack with two wonderful sort of variants that is great for army building and great for anyone who's a collector or interested in Doctor Who or just interested in Daleks in general. I would recommend picking this setup, however it's probably being sold by some scalper called Derek on eBay, and you're probably going to be lucky just to find one of the individuals being sold for 15 each. But yeah, that has been my first review in years. I hope you all enjoyed. I hope you don't get exterminated. And I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.